Everyone had a soft spot for Joey.
He was a hero to a lot of people that he didn't know he was a hero.
When he stepped onto the ice, he came on the ice as part of the Edmonton community, and I think that's what people really enjoyed most.
He's just a fun-loving kid.
He just made us all better people.
The person he was made everybody feel good about themselves.
He is a Canadian icon. He's brought so much positive energy to the city, to our province, and to the country as well.
When I think of Edmonton, when I hear anything going on in Edmonton, I immediately think Joe Moss.
Joe was well-loved. He was a special guy.
It began with a simple act of kindness. Do you think we could find the kid some work? A favor to the greatest player in hockey, and who was going to say no to Wayne Gretzky, that came without real expectations beyond the gesture. Except that wasn't how it turned out. The helping hand extended to Joey Moss was returned many times over. By doing a job and doing it well, by becoming one of the boys, he taught a lesson that so many took to heart. When Joey Moss arrived to help out in the Edmonton Oilers dressing room, he was a kid with Down syndrome. And for many, on first encounter, his disability defined
him. Hi, I'm Joey Moss.
What the Oilers soon came to understand, along with the players on the Edmonton football team, when Moss was hired there, was that you could count on Joey to get things done, to be meticulous and diligent and responsible, and that you could also count on him for some fun. That he could both dish it out and take it. That he could be part of the team. Joey was a natural-born performer, the second youngest of 13 kids who toured with their parents as a family band. He could sing even if he didn't always know the words. He loved to dance. He had the confidence to put himself out there, no matter how big the crowd, with both joy and a bit of the star's swagger. Joey loved professional wrestling. He liked to have a burger and a beer. And he loved his job. There is dignity in honest work, satisfaction in taking on a task, completing it, and completing it well. Those are universal values. Through the job that began as a favor, over the years that followed, those around Joey Moss came to see the fully realized person in their midst. What he taught so many was not how we are different, but what we all share.
Hi, I'm Wayne Gretzky, and I'd love to tell you about my friend Joey. He was such an Edmontonian. He was never down. He was always thrilled. He was always really perky. He never seemed to have bad moments. He was so positive towards all of us. His energy was infectious, and I think we all thrived off of it. He was a special young man. For people who don't know Joey, he was very mature. His mother was very much a believer that he needed to live his life as normal as possible. Back in the 50s when my aunt was born, they would take kids and basically put them in asylums, and my grandmother really didn't want anything to do with that. So she basically grew up on a farm. She was very intelligent. She was very intuitive, and yet she was very mentally challenged. So I kind of grew up with her as our whole family did, and I was very comfortable being in that surrounding. And so when I met Joey, it was nothing sort of new or unique for me. I didn't look at him any differently. You know, I treated him like I would treat anyone else. In the early 80s, we were trying to get these kids more into society. And so he was working at this bottle depot, and it was 40 below, I remember one time, and he was getting on the bus to go to work at 7 a.m. to work from 8 to 4. And I knew he wasn't overly thrilled about having to go to work each and every day. And the odd time I would take him out of work and he'd come to rink, he'd come to practice, he'd hang around. And that's kind of where I got the idea. I thought, you know, there's got to be more to life for this young man. And that's when I sat down with Glenn Sather and asked Glenn if there was any sort of position that we could find for Joey in the locker room. And without hesitation, he said, absolutely. After the first month or so, he was kind of on his own. He would make sure he got there and put the coffee on. He made sure that he had the water bottles filled for practice. He got the pucks out and made sure the pucks were on the bench ready for practice. He would vacuum the locker room. And, you know, the media guys used to stand around me and he didn't care. And he used to take the vacuum, almost vacuum over their shoes. And it kind of became sort of a comedy sketch. It was one of those things where when he started working there, it was great for Joey. But what we found out over time, it was wonderful for us, because after games, especially after tough losses, his smile was infectious and he was very loving and caring. He'd hug the guys and tell them tomorrow will be better. So he became such a positive influence in the locker room. I always say to people, he's won more championships in Edmonton than anybody.
Promise Mess I wouldn't do this.
You know, people often talk about the trade and leaving Edmonton. And it was one of those things where I don't know if Joey really understood what happened when I left the team. I remember my first game back in Edmonton and being in the locker room. That was the first time that I really had a chance to sit down and say, hey, I'm on a different team. And he was teasing. He said, I know Sparky told me I'm not allowed to talk to you today. So we kind of got a kick out of that.
And the orders ask you to welcome now Wayne's biggest fan and friend, Joey Moss.
When I went back for that, it was sort of a grand finale for him because he loved finales. He just really thrived in the real world. He loved life. And so I think that he kind of figured it out, the trade, coming back and retiring, kind of all at that one point in time. And we had a wonderful day and a wonderful night that night. I don't think that we understood when he first started to the person he would become, the importance that he would have on society. And I think what we did as a city and what we did as a team showed people that we treated people with dignity and respect. We respected him because he was a good person. And I think that's what people in Canada saw, that people are tired of bullying and people are tired of less fortunate people getting taken advantage of. And I think that made our country so proud that this young man could be such a important role model for so many people across the country.
We put on a wrestling event for him at Ryan Smith's house for his birthday. And, you know, it's Edmonton, it's minus 30 out. And Smitty had set up this whole ring in the back, and you know, wrestlers came in. And I think there were three matches. So it was legit. It was a huge thing. And we had all our, you know, spouses, everyone was there. And it was pretty cool. And it ended with the guy winning the championship, and he looked right at Joe and he said, now it's your turn, now you get in the ring. And Joe just kind of sat back and his eyes popped up and we're all dying laughing. I'm like, is he actually gonna get in there? And so we kind of, you know, encourage him, and he gets up there and he ended up having a, you know, couple minute long wrestling match with the guy, and he tapped him out, and he won the belt. And it was really cool. It was honestly one of the coolest team parties and team things that I'd ever been a part of.
The city of Edmonton loved Joey Moss as much as Joey Moss loved wrestling. And while Joey was friends with some of the most iconic hockey players in the world, it wasn't people from the rink that Joey idolized, but people from the ring that he looked up to so much. Superstars that were larger than life, like John Cena, The Rock, and Hulk Hogan. To so many people, Joey was larger than life. And we here at the WWE will always consider Joey a part of our WWE family. Joey will forever remain an undefeated champion.
whenever you're with Joey, he just made you feel so comfortable and relaxed, and you know everything was going to be okay.
As soon as you think of him, you think about the fun you've had together and his love that he gives to everyone.
He just lit up the room. Joey would walk in and he'd light up the room.
Joey has shown and proven that just because you have a disability does not mean that you can't get somewhere big. Mm-hmm. Joey climbed the mountain, he got to the top, and he was there for quite a while.
He sure showed them. Just gave people hope.
He would just dig in and make it work, right, with anything you presented in front of him.
I've noticed this sense of powerfulness within himself that I don't think you can be taught that. I think he just felt very, very good in his skin. And so he would adapt. He knew the differences in people and knew how to be in those different situations. But he was always Joey, always. Well, Joey being number 12, at that time we were a family band. The older ones were teenagers, so not that excited about it, but we still knew that was what we needed to do.
Music was like, that was his love. I think Joey was the only one who enjoyed it. I think he stole the show.
He really
the rest
did.
Of us, like, you know.
He'd get on the stage and he would hand it up. And that's what he did for the rest of his life. He could ham it up in front of a crowd. And a natural. Like, it wasn't contrived. It was just, that was him.
From that very early age, I think it was about 3, he learned to become an entertainer just because of the feedback he received from the audience.
Watching the Rexall Place Farewell Celebration and they had Joey get the farewell banner, and when he walked out onto the ice, I think he had a louder cheer than anybody else in that room. The way he walked to get the banner, waiting for the banner, watching it come down, carrying the banner out, and then of course you think it's done, he hands the banner off to his boss, Jeff, and then turns around and puts his hands up. And the crowd just goes nuts again. And he loved the crowd. He loved to make people happy.
Hockey meant a lot to him. He would do his homework. He would have stacks of paper, reams of them. And he would watch a game and he'd keep score. What player scored when and at what time. You know, he knew the stats. He loved doing that.
Joey's left such a wonderful legacy. And I don't think I could pinpoint what it is. I think it's he is an ambassador for our city. So I think that part of him will always be remembered. His love, his joy, his sense of well-being. And I think he's passed it on to many, many, many people.
It was always such a pleasure to be around Joey, that we were the lucky ones to know him, to have a relationship with him, because of everything that he gave back to us, which is joy, love, and happiness.
We'd always have inner squad games, and then they finally said that, hey, let's do the blue and white game. It's Joey Moss.
Everyone wants to win the Joey Moss Cup. I was lucky enough to play in, I think, one or two of them, and it's intense. Everyone wants to win it.
He was really proud of it, and I think the one thing is that often on those days he would come with a shirt and tie and jacket, and he would know that it's the day that one of the guys are getting the cup.
They open it up to the public, and then next thing you know, where it's not just 300 or 400 people, it's the whole lower bowl at the old Rexall, and then it's the whole building, and it's turned into just a big spectacle, and he loved it.
It was a big event for Joey, for sure. I mean, he would come in and make sure that we were prepared for the games and give us a speech, and he'd be dressed up in a suit, and it was what he was all about, you know, the passion. He came out, and you know, the photos after, and he really took a lot of pride in that game.
He would walk out after the game was over, and Joey present the trophy, and Joey would go out there and he'd have the trophy, but he wouldn't want to give it to anybody because he'd want to be the one collecting the cheer. And yeah, he loved it. He loved the limelight.
First time I heard him sing O Canada, the billing was quiet, but there was this guy belting out O Canada. You know, I said to myself, who the hell's that singing O Canada? Wayne goes, that's Joey.
Every once in a while you'd see a guy look over his shoulder thinking, who is this person? And then they'd see it's Joey, and then sure enough, they'd get a chuckle out of it.
It was pretty awesome. You look up and you see him just belting it out, and you had such a awesome feeling in your heart when you saw that every game, for sure.
He'd be singing his heart out, and I just remember thinking, wow, like what an amazing person to be able to get up and do that in front of all these people.
That's Joey Moss for you, you know, like he goes out and he just sings in front of thousands of people, and there's no care at all, and that energy was just so contagious.
Just thinking about it now, it makes me get a little choked up. I see him and I just, you know, busting out this loud voice, and you know, everybody's looking at him, and we're all just like, you know, man, this is what it's all about. This is what, you know, what you play for.
For me, Oilers hockey started and ended with Joe Moss.
Everybody loved him right from the first day that he came into the room.
We said that training camp didn't start till Joey Moss came there.
He was part of the family.
He's Joey Moss. I think I don't need to explain that anymore. Everyone in this city knows him. He's probably the biggest legend in this town.
I feel very lucky to have known him the way I did.
He taught me a few things in my life. And one of the things that he taught me was patience. I didn't know if I wanted any part of this guy. I don't know if this guy wanted any part of me. But in the end, it snowballed that he became an employee, he became a great friend, he became part of my family.
When Wayne brought him aboard, you know, it was not a surprise to me really, because I saw how friendly he was, how happy he was, how capable he was.
Joey was not just in there, you know, full towels and vacuum. Joe was part of that team. He was such a pleasure to be around. And you'd see players who got traded, it's the first thing they would, when they came back, they'd come to see, where's Joey? How's Joey?
He meant so much to me. You know, when I got traded to New Jersey, one of the things I was looking forward to the most about going back to Edmonton was seeing Joey and giving him a hug and just kind of, you know, feeling his energy again.
I remember the first time I got sent down, and Joey was one of the first guys. I was sitting there in my locker room, and they give you like a bag and gotta pack up your own stuff, and you're going back and tears in your eyes because you got cut and you're going back down to minors. And Joey is one of the guys that came up, put his arm around me, says, it's okay, buddy, you'll be back before you know it. And I don't know if he thought I was going to be back or not, but it made you feel good. He made you feel like it was okay, and it was pretty cool.
Having some rough patches during my time as a young kid, you know, trying to find my way in life and what kind of person I want to be. But there's one guy that, you know, I could say that always... you know, just treating me like a person, like a good young kid, and that was Joey Moss.
As a player, you come into the rink and you're always worried about what line you're on and, you know, the game before. And when you walk in and you saw Joe, you forgot about all that stuff.
After losses, I remember sitting down with Joey and you talk to him, try and explain the game and why we'd lost the game, and he wouldn't have anything to do, and you turn and just say, try harder.
The night I had 8 points, it was a really crazy night, obviously pretty special. But then, you know, sitting there after the game, there was a lot of media, different things I had to do, and it took me a couple hours to get out of the rink. And before I left, Joey grabbed a couple beers from the back of the back fridge and said he wanted to celebrate with me.
It just shows how important he was to this organization, not just to this organization, but to this city. You know, when we lost Mosser, it wasn't just the Oilers organization, the city of Edmonton. It was something that hit everyone hard.
Other, you know, young people who, you know, had some of the challenges that Joey had would look up to him. The parents of those children would be inspired to see Joey being such a instrumental figure in the community.
Anybody in Edmonton knows the amount of work with charities that he's done. He's brought so much positive energy to the city, to our province, and to the country as well. So it doesn't faze me, and I firmly believe that he is a Canadian icon.
I think anybody who was an Oilers fan, you know, they think of Stanley Cups and Gretzky and Messier and some of the other Hall of Famers, and now Connor McDavid and, you know, Ryan Smith, and they think of Joe Moss.
Arguably, he's probably the most famous Oiler besides Wayne that ever came through the organization.
He is Oilers hockey personified, and his legacy will be that he was there for that team and that organization and that city every day.
It was just amazing, and he was just such a great guy and such a fun character to be around. Joe meant so much to the Oilers, to the community, to the players and the staff. You know, losing Joe is not only a sad day for the Oilers and Edmonton as a community, but the whole hockey community. You know, we'll miss him greatly.
I had a lot of people say that to me, like, oh, wow, how fortunate Joe was to have that opportunity to be around us. And, you know, I always looked at it the other way around. I mean, every day I got to spend with Joey, I consider myself lucky.
Our organization got a lot more out of this than Joey did. And, you know, when we look forward, hopefully we can have the players talk about Joey Moss, not tomorrow, but 20 years from now, because that's the impact he had on the Oilers organization.
You know, he's just a fun-loving kid. Maybe it brought out the kid in all of us, so he just made us all better people.
I miss him. I love him. I'll think of him all the time. He's like, truly like a son to me. And I'm blessed to have him in my life. I've had him in my life.
I'm going to miss his honesty. I'm going to miss his sense of humor. You know, I miss everything about him. Right now, I can honestly say I really miss my friend.
Joe is such an inspiration to all of us. You know, we miss you. We miss you, Joe. You always put joy on our faces.
He always had those famous playoff speeches. He loved a mic, and you put a mic in his hand, and he would go on and on. But his speeches to go into the playoffs were always fun for everybody. He was a special person, and Joey will always love you.
Joey, we will never forget you. You were the light of the dressing room, and even after losses, you always there smiling to cheer us up.
Joey was always there, and the opportunity to see Joey every day brought a smile to my face, and it didn't matter how things went during a game or not. It was great to see Joey and spend time, talk to Joey. It's just, he means that much to me and will always have a special place in my heart.
The things that he taught us as human beings and individuals and teammates, those things will always be reminded in my daily life.
I think Joey did what he did best was he kept the game in perspective the way it needs to be. We're a group, we're a family, coming together to try and win a Stanley Cup. Those are some great lessons from a great person. We're going to miss you, Joe.
There's one saying that I'll always remember, and Joey said it often, and it was, feel good. Why not? And he's 100% right. And this world needs a lot more Joey Mosses. It'd be a lot better place.